All right, thanks, Pete. Rob Lake joins us in the studio with your, I guess you didn't bring your magic and illusion, but this is, you got the biggest traveling illusion show in the world?
That's right.
Dang, what's that look like when you travel?
Four semi-trucks and about 20-plus people who travel all over with me.
Wow, and you got here in June.
Yeah, so we've been here almost a month now.
Uh-huh. So kind of, I've not seen the show yet. I'm dying to see it. But give people maybe the big picture of what you do. This isn't, you know, just you're not pulling rabbits out of a hat. Or maybe you do.
No, you're right. I don't do that. It's like you said, it's the largest touring illusion show in the world. So I handpicked my favorite illusions to bring to Lake Tahoe for the summer. Uh-huh. I make people levitate. I do a lot of audience participation. I make a motorcycle disappear. It's a pretty grand scale production.
Wow, that's cool. How'd you get started? So you grew up in Oklahoma.
I did.
And then how did you get started? Did you start with magic first? Do you have comedy mixed into the show?
I have a lot of fun, so it is comedic at times. I started doing magic when I was about 10 years old. I saw a magic show, and I knew immediately that's what I wanted to
Isn't
do.
Isn't that great? Yeah.
Yes.
It's great. And I was asking you during the commercial break, you know, how is it? You just said you couldn't imagine doing anything else. I mean, it looks grand just looking at this performance. Are you coming up with new illusions constantly? Are you constantly working on new ones?
Always. The show is always growing and changing. Even during the middle of the show, I might tell my crew, hey, I have an idea. What if we changed this or did this? So it's always evolving, and I make it very interactive. So audience comes up on stage a lot. We bring the magic into the audience a lot just to make it very, very fun, interactive, and that also makes it change regularly.
That's incredible. So when you started, it started with magic, and then it evolves into illusion, or to you, are they both the same?
They're almost the same. Magic is kind of the umbrella, and illusion is a type of magic. Illusion is the grand scale stage production of magic. And so I am a magician and also an illusionist both. So they're almost interchangeable.
So what do you do? Because you know, I've got a 5-year-old daughter, and you know, you can imagine how easy it is for me to pull off a magic trick. You know,
sure.
I can just pull a penny out of her ear that's in my head. It's super easy.
Right.
But she always wants to know how you did it, and then she's now coming up with some magic tricks and then wants to tell me how you did it. Isn't that like part of what's challenging is, oh, Rob, how'd you do that? I mean, how do you answer that?
You don't.
Exactly.
Ultimately, you don't. But no, people do want to know how it works, but more importantly for me is the experience of magic and wonder and excitement. So, yeah, they do say how that happened, but a few minutes into the show, they give up on that, just sit back, enjoy it, and almost believe for a while.
That's it. That's the whole thing is just enjoy what you're seeing, enjoy
Absolutely.
The experience of it. What would you say of all the, how long have you been doing it then?
I mean, I started when I was 10 and I'm 34 now. So,
wow.
Yeah.
That's
so 24
years. Can you
That's
guys
right.
run the numbers on that?
Let's put a graphic up for that.
It is. It's 24
That's
years.
Right.
It's 24. What of all those, do you have one that's like your staple? You got to have the spaghetti and meat sauce when you have go to this restaurant. Do you have like one illusion you got to see Rob Lake do this?
There are actually a few of those. I like I said, I handpicked all of my favorites. Sometimes it can take 5, 6, 7 years to put an illusion on the stage.
Wow.
So that much dedication and practice and rebuilding and trial and error, they almost become like children. So it's hard to pick just one favorite thing I do, but it's very, but there's several like that I've really poured myself into for many years. So those are the ones I really look forward to every night.
That's awesome. So you're at Harrah's, and you're here until when?
All the way through Labor Day.
Mm-hmm. And is it, what days are you doing?
Almost every night.
Uh-huh.
Almost every night.
When do you get a break?
There are a few Tuesdays and Wednesdays in August we get off.
Oh, God, yeah. You must be. What do you do all day when you're
Sleep
not working?
Sleep and recover.
Is that right, huh?
Yeah. No. We do rehearsal. We're working on some new illusions, so... Believe it or not, I've been here a month. I still have not been to the lake yet.
Oh, I was just going to ask you, like, what do you think so far, Lake Tahoe?
No, it's gorgeous. The scenery I've seen is absolutely beautiful, and the people in the community are so nice.
That's good. I'm glad to hear that. Rob Lake, everybody, go see the show. It's here till Labor Day. When we come back, your 7-day Lake Tahoe forecast.